Are you tired of manually tracking your e-commerce data in Google Analytics 4? Look no further. In this video, we will show you how to set up one-click e-commerce tracking with a GTM template for Google Analytics 4. Say goodbye to the hassle of manual tracking and hello to accurate automated data. So without further delay, let's get started. Before, we have need to create GTM account. Just go to tagmanager.google.com, enter your account name, choose your country and enter your business name GA4 and select the web and create. Here is my Google Tag Manager container. Now we have need to the set up Shopify data layer. You have need to the any data layer. Here is my data layer. Contact me if you need data layers. Okay, now we have need to create the, this is the first head code, and go to your Shopify store and go to the theme and go to the edit code theme liquid, just enter and paste here the render head code, save and copy the render body, copy the body code and go to the theme.liquid and go down and find the where is the body end. Here is the end and here is the body, here is the body opening body. Okay, just enter and again paste the your body code and save. Now we have need to create a three snippets. Okay, first we have need to copy the snippets name, go to the snippets and create a add new snippets and enter your snippets name and done, and go to the this doc file and copy the all body code. Okay, copy the all body code and copy the body code and go to the your body end, paste it the body end and just replace the your Google GTM container ID. Go to the your Google GTM container and copy the GTM container ID. Here is my GTM container ID, copy and go to the your store and just replace the your GTM container ID. Only one time you have need to the container ID and again you have replaced the container ID, just save and copy the again go to create a snippet, just paste the name and done, and go to the doc file and copy the checkout end script. Okay, this is a data layer script. And copy the data layer script and paste and again replace the GTM container ID. Replace the GTM container ID and save. And we have already, and we need to the, these are head snippets. There is the head snippets and create a new snippets. Again paste the snippets name, done, and go to the doc file and copy the snippets code and paste the snippets code on the abbreviated snippets and copy the again Google Tag Manager ID and replace the Google Tag Manager ID again and again. Our this snippets created are done. Now go to the exit and we have need to create the we have need to copy the checkout script. Okay, just copy the checkout script and copy the checkout script and go to the setting and go to the checkout and go down and this is my old script and just copy the this checkout script and paste here the checkout script. Now we have need to the replace the Google GTM container ID. Copy the GTM container ID and go to the checkout and replace the container ID. We have need to again replace the container ID and as you can see here is as you can see here is the GTM container ID, just replace. And we have one time more need to replace the container ID. Our data layer enable is done. Now if I go to the Shopify view online store and if I visit any product and if I open the here is the Google Chrome extension for data layer checker, and as you can see here is our data layer is working perfectly, is working right now. Okay, if I select the product add to cart, and if I go to the data layer checker, and as you can see here is the add to cart is working. And if I go to the view cart by any product remove cart, if I go to the data layer, and as you can see here is our remove cart data layer is working. Now we have need to create a improve the GTM template. I will provide in the video description box. Okay, just download and input your GTM container. Go to the admin section and select the input container and choose the your container file. I will provide this file. Okay, select the GA4 browser all events template by Moonlight GTM template, and select the existing, select the default workspace and just confirm. Okay, if I go to the tag, and as you can see here is our all template is imported, done. If I go to the triggers, here is, you can see here is all ready triggers, it's already have. If I go to the variables, you don't need to create any variables, triggers or tags. Okay, and as you can see here is the all variables are available. You don't have need to create any text, triggers or variables, just you have need to replace the GA4 base tech configuration. Just you have need to replace the measurement ID. Where is the measurement ID? You go to the Google Analytics, analytics.google.com, enter your GF, enter your business name. Okay, and go to the next and enter your property name, select the GA4 and select your county, your time zone. Okay, just go to next, and as you can see here is the business information. You can choose your industry. Google help you to optimize your business, it will suggest you how you can optimize your business. Okay, this is a very important. Choose the some your business related checkbox and just create. Okay, and here this is my GA4 container, and now we have not need to go to the data stream and select the add data stream and select the web, and yes, there enter your website URL. If I go to the visit store and copy the your store URL, here is the Google and store, enter your store URL and enter your store name or your business name, and just create a data stream. I am already created. Now I am showing, I am using this the data stream. Click the data stream, copy the measurement ID. Okay, and if I go to the Google Tag Manager again, just replace the measurement ID and save. Our GA4 e-commerce tracking is done. Now we have need to check the is perfectly working or not. Now we have need to the test and publish. Before I have published, you can ignore this or publish this. Continue. And if I go to the analytics debug view, and go to the Google Tag Manager preview option, and you must have the analytics debug view for the testing. Here is my store, paste your online store, just copy the store and enter your store and continue. Now you can see our preview mode is connected. Okay, now if I go to the GA4 debug view, and as you can see here is our data is coming from Google, and here is the showing is Google, and test our event is working or not. If I visit the any product and visit the add to cart, view cart, remove cart, and go to the busy home page, now as you can see here is our all events is working. Here is our view cart event, and our all data is perfectly working, and add to cart, remove cart, view cart is perfectly working. If I go to the remove cart, if I open the remove cart, and as you can see all event parameter is perfectly working. Okay, and if I visit the any product again, restart add to cart and checkout. And if I enter the my information and continue to shipping and continue payment, and I am adding a temporary card, and where is the I am adding any temporary card. This is the testing payment method. If I select the pay now, and your order is being processed. Our purchase is done. Our purchase is done. If I go to the tag assistant and summary, our purchase is done. As you can see, here is our we have purchased our two products. If I go to the my store, and as you can see, here is a purchase of two products. If I go to the analytics, and as you can see, if I visit the purchase, and as you can see, here is the two items. It's perfectly working. Is our currency is working. If I go to the shipping is our tax, is these are tax price or transaction ID. Here is the word transaction ID. Okay, is the transaction ID, and here is the value. Here is the our value 12787. If I go to store 12787, here is the our product value. And if I go to the view item, as you can see, our view item is working perfectly. Everything is working. Remove card parameters is working. Our recommended events is perfectly working. And remove card or view card, and visitor type is guest visitor. Okay, it is all everything. It's perfectly working. And this is the our GA4 e-commerce tracking tutorials. Hopefully this video will help you. If you found this tutorial helpful, please don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more e-commerce tracking tips and tricks. Also, please share this video with anyone who might find it useful, and you can don't hesitate to contact me for Shopify data layer code. Thank you so much for watching this tutorials.